Welcome back to the Heart of GAFCON. Dominic Steele here, and we're talking to people across the Anglican Communion. We're going to Uganda now, and the Archbishop of Uganda. Thanks for coming in, Stephen Kazimba.
You're welcome.
How are you finding the conference so far?
The conference is excellent. It is a time of meeting friends, a time of putting our heads together to see how we can forge our way forward for a renewal, revival, and reorder of the Anglican Communion.
I heard those three words used by Bishop Keith Sinclair so well in the last session.
Yeah, they are so wonderful, because the gospel is about repentance, which is after the resurrection, resuscitation, reconciliation, revival, reformation. It's about reorder. So it's very, very important that our time here will result into repentance, which is also a call for reconciliation, but also renewal and reorder of the Anglican Communion, the way it should go after the fabric of the Communion was broken by sin, which was caused by the Church of England and also Episcopal Church of America, plus others.
What's your message been to Archbishop Welby? Because you've known him for a long time.
I am disappointed, because in Uganda, the message of the gospel came from Church of England in 1877. The first missionaries came. And so we had polygamy as a normal way of marriage, and every man had 3, 4, 5 women, and they chased their wives because of the gospel. And now when we hear a message that now even a man can have another man as a wife, or same-sex marriages is also marriage, we get disappointed that those who brought the gospel to us are turning away from what they brought to us. So our message is, for us in Uganda, we still keep the gospel in its totality. We cannot embrace liberalism and confucianism. So we just call upon Archbishop Justin to repent, and in July or any other given time, they should really reverse the decision they made, which is destroying the Anglican Communion. They should reverse, otherwise that is so sad in his time as an Archbishop of Canterbury.
A terrible thing to happen on his watch.
It is so terrible. Actually, it will be remembered like you remember in Apostles' Creed, Jesus suffered during the time of Pontius Pilate. Pontius Pilate. All creeds we talk about. So it will be remembered that the Anglican Communion was broken during the time of Justin Welby.
This week, what are you hoping to come out of this week?
I'm looking forward to our meeting as primates this afternoon, but also the statement that will come out of this meeting, the communique. My expectation is that there will be focusing on one thing together, the gospel, focusing on Jesus, especially the theme, which is very important. To whom should go? We should go to Jesus. We should really be committed to work together more than ever before. Africa, Native America, Africa, Latin America, Americas, Australia. We need to work together to ensure that we follow the way of the gospel. Where others have forsaken Jesus and the right teaching, we should stick to the gospel, and we need each other more than ever before.
If we come back to the question of reordering of the Anglican Communion, what do you think or hope that might look like?
Actually, I would see that GovCon, Global South, if they all come together. I think leadership can be rotating, because it's not about taking power, it's about definitely empowering each other, supporting each other, inviting, like now GovCon is more in mission, mission, conferences, retreats, training, which should be very key. Encouraging one another, this should be the most important things. But there should be an element of discipline. Because the reason why we have had all this, there is no element of disciplining those who have gone out of the way. Because Canterbury, we had Archbishop, we have Lambeth, we have Anglican Council, we have a Consultative Council, and we have the primates. But there isn't anything which you would say this is an arm to discipline those who have gone astray. So I think in a reordering, that should be something to be considered. Otherwise, you know, human beings are human beings. You can have these people coming together, and then because there is no discipline, they can do others, they can even create something else which will be also a source of division. But now, let us wait for a statement and the way forward together this week. I am grateful that we have this conference, and my prayer is that at the end of it all, we'll continue to love one another, Church of Australia, Africa, America, Asia. This is what we need, and we continue to see Jesus Christ more than ever before. Let us promote the gospel. Let us promote repentance, renewal, recommitment, revival, reformation, resuscitation, and reorder of the Anglican Church, so that the gospel will continue to be preached. The way to heaven is not in Canterbury. The way to heaven is in Jesus. So we don't need to be worried, if now there is no going in Canterbury. No, we don't have any scripture to say, unless you go in Canterbury, you cannot go in heaven. No. So we need to, like for me, I was made a bishop in 2008, in October, after Canterbury and GovCon. But I found GovCon so enriching and rewarding, and his friendship, and found they really stick to scripture and revival. And for us in Uganda, because of the coming of missionaries and teaching the Bible, we got some younger men and women who were persecuted and burnt alive. They put in fire for the gospel because of the gospel that was brought by the missionaries from England. So we cannot betray those men who were killed for the gospel by going backward. And in Uganda, we have what, the June 3rd, Martyrs Day. 45 men were burnt singing for Jesus because of the gospel that the British brought to us. So now when we mess up that, we betray those men and women who were killed. So GovCon is putting us in the real image of the gospel. We are ready to defend it. We want to go back and teach our people to follow the Jerusalem Declaration, to stick the Bible, because that's the word of the Lord.
Thank you so much for coming to talk to us. Archbishop Stephen Kazimba has been our guest. He is the primate of the Anglican Church of Uganda.
Thank you. God bless you. Stick to Jesus.
Absolutely. Thanks, sir.